The next question. Okay. Okay. Intense questions today. Susan, SOS from Israel. We are under heavy pressure of mandatory participation of a huge trial of the Vax'ines material. My daughter and their partners are under big pressure of losing their jobs without the Vax'ines. They are close to surrender to the pressure. Feels to me like the years of Holocaust are playing out again, this time orchestrated by our own people. Until now, I tried to influence them to oppose the pressure, but feel now I have to surrender to the situation and let them handle their own lives. Dear Jess, do you have any insights for me? How can I the best support for my beloved ones? And what lesson have I and the people of Israel to learn this time? Have the calm knowledge that I don't want. I have the calm knowledge that I don't want to take it. Okay. I'll try not to spend an hour here because I definitely could spend six. All right. So just like I was explaining in the first question, that all energy that is created and becomes dense, lower frequencies, pain, suffering, right? All of those lower energies, they're too heavy to lighten up and return back to source energy. Okay, so it's contained energy. And I like to call this the ghosting effect. Like some of you get ghosted, this will actually help you understand why. So whenever there is a big event, a big trauma, an abuse, a addiction that separates consciousness, a major, major loss, right? War, genocide, famine, anything that is just truly, completely moving and residing in dense frequency stays dense. Now, if it stays dense, it stays here. So, you know, some of you have watched these like ghost hunting shows and you're like, oh my gosh. And you go to this old house and there's ghosts walking around, haunting the place. Well, hello to the Holocaust. So the Holocaust still vibrates and still walks around, haunting the place. Now, the frequency of the Holocaust is grief. Grief. Okay. It is not anger. It is not, it's grief. It's 100% loss. It's suffering, it's starvation, it's separation, it's, you know, dominance control, it's lack of freedom, it's lack of choice. So imagine all those little ghosts walking around, okay? And that's just in one area, okay? And so that area, okay, so imagine everybody who lost their life in the Holocaust or lost part of themselves in that incarnation. Part of them returned home to go, you guys, source energy, pull up a chair, get some popcorn. I've got a story to tell you. And everyone in source energy is like, oh my gosh, what are you saying? What do we do? Okay, let's create a plan, because the part of us that actually had to go through the death experience or watch our loved one die or see our mom starve to death could not make it because there was too much pain. So they had to stay. So we need a reconnaissance mission, right? So just like the first question, we set sail to come back from the future reality, because there's no such thing as time and space, but I'm using this idea to come back and recover ourselves. So of course, we're always going to be returning to the scene of the crime in every incarnation until we close the circuit, until we move out of love, out of loss, back into love. Out of lack into abundance, away from no choice to choice, move to trapped and jailed to freedom. And it's moment by moment by moment by moment, because I mean, even if we were just going to look at the Holocaust, look at the time space that has existed since that event and look at who we have become, right? So we are all kind of coming back and like collecting ourselves. And because Earth is such an amazing holographic space, because everything can coexist here in perfect harmony. Doesn't appear like perfect harmony, but it is, because pain, suffering work really well with the higher levels because it illuminates. So what our job here is to do is, if you're in any part of that space, any part of your incarnation that is deliberately associated or attached or remembered or assigned to that idea or another idea. I mean, some people are reconciling their years of slavery. Some people are reconciling their years of genocide, right? War, famine, you know, starvation. You know, it's like, I'm a woman, trust me, there's a lot of pain inside that DNA just as is, okay? So now we put different colored bodies out there who have experienced different things. Now we have Holocausts. Now we have, you know, religious wars. Now we have money wars. Now we have drug wars, right? Now we have blood wars. We've got it everything. And there's a part of you that was there. And there was a part of you that was there, which means that most of the time you have been both victim and perpetrator somewhere. So part of you doing the dirt, part of you receiving the dirt. So as we start to come back, this is what a light worker is, start coming back and going, I got to find myself. The way you find yourself is you dive all the way down into the story of starvation. You know, the story of suffering, the story of being judged for your religious choices, or even hurt or killed, or forced vaccines. So, Susan, I've worked with you over the years, so when I speak, I know you're going to hear me. Your job here and now is to step out of your story. This is actually the only way you're going to repower yourself. You need to step out of this story, and you need to kind of move back into the space of the observer. Because once you actually kind of get out of the attachment of these being your children and these children being forced against their will, taking their choices, and possibly killed for this vaccine, we don't know, right? It is too much for that loss part of you. When you're in a loss, you are separated from source energy. So you cannot be in loss and connect back to love. How you speak to your girls, your kids, your partner, is through the telepathic heart nature of the heart, which means you have to be in a state of either neutrality or love for you to send the energy message to them and have them receive it. If you are calling them, telling them, don't take this, don't take this, don't do this, you forgot you're an actor playing in a movie designed to rescue yourself. I need you to pull out. I need you to step out of the story. I need you to take a breath. Breath means spirit. Bring your breath into the body. Okay, I'm going to observe this. I'm going to step out of the movie theater into the hall, grab some popcorn. And while I'm in the hall, I can think about the movie that's going on in there. When I'm watching the movie and the music is triggering and there's people dying, I feel this is real and I'm having a visceral experience. But if I can get into the hallway where I can smell the popcorn, I'm good. I need you in the hallway with the popcorn. Okay, so hallway popcorn, take a breath. Think about the story I just told, right? This is a blueprint. This is a reconnaissance mission. This is a treasure hunt. This is me physically focused, having the experience of being unconscious. When I feel pain, I have no longer a cell signal to source energy. When I feel lack, when I feel scared, because if I feel scared, I'm anticipating loss, and you could never lose anything connected to spirit, never, ever. So I need to pull out, take a breath. Whew. Something that helped me early on was, this is just a dream. This is just a dream. This is just a dream. I don't care what you have to say, because it is. It's just a dream. Feels real. They feel like your kids. Of course, they are connected to your soul fabric, your tribe, your family of clustered spirits. So yes, they mean a lot to you, but there is no such thing as death. There is only transcendence. So I need you to get to that space where you're either in a state of neutrality, a state of understanding, or a state of remembering. And then I need you to remember who you are truly. You're not an actor in this movie. You are playing the part to go collect yourself undercover as you to go get you, not to stop your girls from taking a vaccine. Okay. So if you can return back to yourself, take a breath, remember who you are. Know this is all a holographic experience and that the pain that you're feeling is loss or anticipation of loss, concern, worry, fear, resentment, shame, guilt, all those lower frequencies, right? You can say, okay, my job is to get back to the feeling of love. So if you did Master of Love workshop, which I don't think I saw you in there, that's okay. I'm going to give you the love frequencies. And you might need to pause this part of the recording and say this over and over again, because this is going to be your formula to move the energy out of attached, witnessed manifestation to divine creator, choice, and understanding. So I appreciate that this is an experience to awaken us all. By a pandemic and forced lack of choice, we are starting a rebellion, a revolution, and we are all moving back into ourselves. Take a breath. I'm giving you the love frequencies. Okay. I allow my children, who I have sponsored as souls, to be the guiding light and example for them, to understand that all choices are valid and safe, and that the body is designed to heal itself, and the higher in a evolution of love that they can transcend, the more they will be completely unfazed from anything that they ingest, do, or take. Okay? You're going to have to stay with me here because your ego is going, no, they don't know what they don't know. Doesn't matter. Remember, hearts are telepathic. You are speaking light language to the heart of those children when you move out of loss. You are not saving them when you're worried about them. You are saving them when you accept them. You are helping them remember through the heart when you allow them. Okay, so I understand and accept that they may need to be experiencing this to awaken them greater. Pain is our greatest first teacher. Suffering is our greatest first teacher. And I have survived many, many, many poisonous things and still become who I am. So I know that my children will have a negative equals shortcut, fantastic experience from whatever they choose. I will continue to love their choice. I receive divine guidance to further send to them through the stream of love. I indulge in ideas of a beautiful unified space as I'm in the hallway of this movie theater. I see a world that is becoming unified because they are understanding that they have lacked choice. They are understanding that they are being poisoned, and they are remembering that they are creators. Okay? I flow and allow. Okay? I witness myself versus being the character in my movie when I get scared. I share what I know through the heart, not through the words. Okay? I connect with the stream of consciousness, source energy, where I know thyself. I return to my gamma energy. Through theta, I can move to the space of the divine. And I remember that I am. Okay? I am here to be free, demonstrate freedom, and be the reflection and the example of love. I am not here to be the reflection of loss. I am not here to be the reflection of pain. I am not here to be the reflection of what could go wrong when I create my reality. Okay. I have the sight of where we are heading in humanity. I have chosen a job and a purpose that keeps me plugged in, tapped in to all future laws and decisions making in the universe. Because in Israel is the center point of all communication through all the chakras of not only the world, but the cosmos. The 23rd of March represents the divine activation point for me to further reconstruct, resurrect myself, and remember myself greater through the wormhole of creation itself. Right on time, March 11th. You got 2 weeks to practice this. Okay. I am open to all experiences that will take us to a fast track. And I have learned that sometimes negatives are shortcuts and detours to the ultimate realization that I am creator. Take a breath. You're going to say all this to yourself out in the hallway. Okay? Your ego is probably like, don't do it. It doesn't work. Do it anyways. Practice it. Practice it. It's going to feel like writing with your other hand. Do it anyways. You've just practiced suffering and loss, thinking that loss is love your whole life. If you worry about your kids, you're a good mom. Nope. You're a good mom when you allow and accept and become the example of love and say little and feel more. Okay? We're a better parent when we're parenting in the hallway than watching our kids fall down and trying to save them. Because in the hallway, you remember that the kids need to fall down to wake up. And I will tell you guys, any of you that are worried about the loved ones taking the vaccine, or if you should take the vaccine, or people who are not taking the vaccine, whatever side of the fence you are seeing your own reality through, and there is no choice that is wrong or right here. It's just a personal belief system. Understand that all frequency and vibration is changeable through epigenetics of the body when Creator is present. So if I am present in my body, which means I have grounded my energy and I have breathed myself in and I am practicing my theta gamma frequencies of I am that I am, even if I don't believe I am that I am, then what I am going to do is I am going to transcend any frequency, vibration, vaccine, drug, chemtrail, you know, brainwash through the transcendent art of Creator, which means I'm not going to push it away. I'm going to make it into something beautiful. I'm going to take that vaccine, right? And I'm going to turn it into something cool. Now, here's the crazy part about this vaccine, and I actually hope that this goes on YouTube. The crazy part of this vaccine. So let's take the story of superheroes. Let's take the story of Spider-Man, right? This is a boy that was in love. Isn't it interesting that it starts with love? A deep desire for love for Mary Jane, MJ, right? Interesting how hemp always comes in. Always comes in. So story of a boy who is in love, but doesn't have the voice, doesn't have the strength, doesn't have the confidence, doesn't have the will, doesn't have the talent to feel worthy enough to step into love. I love this metaphor for this particular question. So Spider-Man, all right, let's say the spider, radioactive, is the vaccine, all right? So in order to keep my job, I got to take the vaccine. So I got to get bit by a spider, right? So here's what two things are going to happen. If that call for love didn't exist in that little boy's body, that spider would have killed him, right? Now, if you're here in this time and space, most of us are calling back to love from an unconscious place and a conscious place. So the dark part of you is calling for help, even if you don't think you are, and the light part of you is sending the help or being the help, and it's just emerging back. So let's say we take this vaccine and we are in a state of remembering love, remembering ourselves. We have something to live for. We have something to love. We have something to do here. We have, you know, hope. Then honestly, and I cannot tell you enough that every negative is a shortcut, you guys, that this vaccine could technically turn on your superhuman powers. And you're like, really, Jazz? Yes, because what was designed to sedate you or to empower and encase you technically sets you free if we look at history, right? It's like you push someone enough, they're going to stand up for themselves. Now, there are hormones and DNA in your body that are designed to take you to higher dimensions, which means accessing more energy, more power, more knowing. Right? Less gravity because we're not so dense. The story of that kind of superhuman was a prophecy told by your future self to never ever worry about falling into a vat of poison unless you're already deciding and choosing poison. Story of the Joker, right? Let me get revenge. So we're going to see a culture designed to create mass genocide Turn into freaking superheroes, guaranteed, quote me, check in 2 years and be like, Jess, you're so right. So it's a win-win. If you're going to teach your kids anything, do not teach them to resist the vaccine and put them into fear that they're being brainwashed and controlled. Remind them of their power. Remind them of love. Remind them of what they're doing here. And if you cannot speak them where they hear you, demonstrate, 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 demonstrate. And if you're having a hard time with your children, it's because you're having a hard time with you. That is your job, right? And when you lighten up, you begin to make others feel safe in your understanding, in your lack of resistance. The more you resistance, the more you're going to create a reality where you have to experience worst case scenario to wake you up. Shut up, Jess. That's enough. Okay? Hope that helps, because you have all the power, but you need to step out. You need to remember that this is all virtual movie sequences designed, written, edited, directed, and co-created by me, myself, and I. Okay? Your children chose you for a reason. You chose them. You don't activate super consciousness through loss. You activate it through love. Okay? And I'm going to read the loss frequencies just so you know what they are. I feel rejected. I feel abandoned. I feel casted out. I feel unseen. I feel that the ones who hurt me have no remorse. I have no path. People don't see me. People don't hear me. People don't love me. I am worthless. I am unworthy. I am valued less. Okay? I'm not free to be me. I am not allowed to be authentic. And I am not safe to be myself. You see how when I said the loved ones, completely night and day.